Listen. You're in a privileged position to learn a thing or two. Keep your mouth shut and your eyes open.
What's going on today? New day, another day, another dollar. Here to break off another video. Talk about a pretty interesting one, so let's go right in. I'm going to talk about today's Proposition 8 out in California. Now, Proposition 8, it was a proposition that would so to endorse or say marriage also includes a man and a woman. Now, that was shut down by the voters of California. Good job. But it got overturned, I think, in the state courts, and it went through all that rigmarole. Then it went to the federal court, and the decision to the ban Prop 8 was upheld by a 2-1 decision. Okay. They said it served no purpose, and it would lessen the status for gays, like, as far as humanity, this, that, and the fifth, whatever. All right, whatever. My problem is, where are all the so-called religious people, and overall in general, with all these states passing some form of this bill, like lots of states done it, like New York, Massachusetts, D.C., not a state, but they did it. Washington's the next on board. California's going to do it sooner or later. That's probably going to go to the Supreme Court. My problem is with all of you religious people, and I'm going to tailor this to all these religious people also on Facebook and YouTube. Like, there are some out there that are doing it, but it's not what you would think. My problem is, when it comes to topics like this, like gay marriage, a lot of you people fold up your religious tent. Like, a lot of you, and I notice this a lot of you will say stuff just to say it, like, just to put on the air, the appearance that you're religious. You want to talk about God, left and right, this, that, and the fifth, whenever it's convenient for you. But when it comes to topics like this, all of a sudden, you guys want to, like, back off and be like, oh, live and let live, live and let live. You don't give some type of stuff like that. Where I have a problem with you because you're not really religious. You're religious when you want to be religious. Because the point is, you can't pick and choose. If your religion states X, Y, Z, you can't pick C, D, A, F, and G as your principles to live by. You got to live by the whole nine. And a lot of you aren't doing it. And I'm telling, like, Facebook, they do it too. I see a lot of people on Facebook that will quote you religious crap left and right. When you talk about this, all of a sudden they're going to be like, well, why don't you just let people be? And I see. Or I get this one a lot. Well, who are you exactly to judge? I'm going to answer that question first and foremost. Now, in all three books, you all know, like, when I say the three books, I mean like the Torah, the Quran, and like the Bible. So I'm talking about. I'm not talking about anything else, so don't come with your little comments. What about so-and-so says this? I could care less. I don't care about Kabbalism. I don't care about none of that. What they say is it's forbidden, basically. It's banned. It's a sin. It's a act against nature and an act against God. Okay, we get that. Now, you want to yell at my child, jump down my throat, talking about who am I to judge? Well, if you're God, now pay attention, because some of you schlep rocks are pretty stupid on this point, so I want y'all to pay attention. When your God has judged something to be immoral, something that can send you to hell, or whatever version of hell you believe in, if he's already said that already, then it's okay for you to say that you don't believe in something that your God says that he doesn't believe in. Like, he's told you, it's in your scriptures, and it's in everything. It says it. It says what it says about it. I'm not going to go further and cite it. I'm not going to recite it for you guys. You know what it says. But a lot of you people, I'm beginning to think a lot of you religious people are just atheists and just want to say something. And what really kills me is when you got the homosexual religious people. I'm like, seriously? Really? It's like that? I'm like, wow. I see, like, I can respect Farrakhan and Pastor John Hagee for what their views are on this, because they're sticking by what they believe in. Me, personally, I'm not going to vote for it, because I just don't, like, I could care less what you do as long as you're not hurting people. Like, if you're not hurting anybody, live your life. I could care less. But if you expect me to endorse or co-sign a deviant behavior, if I pass gay marriage or I vote for it, I give my stamp of approval, my seal of approval, I might as well give my stamp for, like, you know, bestiality, for, like, guys sleeping with kids and shit. I might as well give my, it's all the same. And, like, people are going to, like, give you different alternatives and, like, say, well, that's not the same. Yes, it is the same. Like, people want to compare it to race. It has nothing to do with race. And like a lot of, I'm gonna talk to like a lot of minorities right now. A lot of like, especially blacks and Hispanics. Y'all be falling for that stupid stuff that they pull on y'all, tugging your heartstrings off. Well, what about the blacks and Hispanics? I'm like, I ain't trying to hear that, because me, my race had nothing to do with me sleeping with a dude. It's two separate things. Like, you want to say, well, it's comparable. You can compare it all you want. It's like comparing apples to oranges. Like, me, myself laying with another man has nothing to do with me being a black dude. But, like, at the end of the day, like, a lot of you religious people, you're not on the ball, because, like, I don't know how this is passing with people in states that are, like, and I know America's, like, what, 80-90% religious? How is this stuff passing? How are you endorsing this bull, this BS, and how are you endorsing this? Like, a lot of y'all people aren't religious. Y'all just, like, faking the game. You just frauds and phonies. But when I say stuff like this, y'all want to get mad at me, but look in the mirror. It is what it is. Like, and what gets me is, like, a lot, like, the Lieutenant Governor of California said, what did he say? He said, it's a victory for the fundamental principles of America. You know, that all people are equal and deserve equal rights and equal treatment under the law. Okay, I can go with that. Now, but if you go with that statement right there, if you want equal treatment, don't get mad when somebody who's in the bestiality files a lawsuit or tries to file where it's okay to do that. Or once again, when these sicko child molesters, they try to go, like, people say, well, that's illegal. What, because you said it is? What people vote for and say, I mean, come on now. At the end of the day, a lot of you people need to step up your religious game, because you're fakes and phonies. And that's why I don't respect a lot of people, because they'll say one thing. They're politicians, like people, especially going on Facebook, man, because they don't want to hear me when I start talking this. Everybody starts like talking about something else. They go left to center. You want to pass gay marriage? That's fine. But if you open that crack to deviancy, don't get mad when everybody starts bum rushing the door down. All right? So, with that said, I'm out of here. Peace. Later.